Hey guys, how's it going? It's Techie Junior here, and this video I'm going to explain the process of rooting, its advantages, disadvantages, and the method by which you can get root in your phone. This video is intended for those Android users who have just bought a new Android phone and want to root their phone but they don't know what is root or how to root their phone. So this video is for them. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get right into it. First and foremost, what is rooting? Rooting is nothing but getting super user privileges, administrator privileges into your phone. By default, phone manufacturers stop non-system applications from getting into the system files and essentially you. By rooting, you can remove the restriction and the system files can get accessible to you. In Windows, Mac or any other computer, you may know this better as running as administrator option for applications. However, as you will see later on in this video, rooting in Android is more complicated than just clicking the run as administrator button in your computer. So you guys might be wondering why you would want to get root access and get access to the system files of your device. Well, there are a number of advantages of getting root access in your device. The first is system customization. If you're not happy with the way your device looks, you can get root access and change all that. By editing the system files, you can change the fundamental look of your device. If you don't like the battery icon, you can change that. If you don't like the icons provided by your device for the apps, you can change that. You can change the ringtones, you can change the sound made by your device by locking and unlocking. You can change the boot up animation of your device. Like, there's a lot you can do when you get root access. The second reason is changing operating systems. If you're still not happy with your operating system as a whole, you can completely replace it with a new operating system which is quite dynamic and good looking and allows you to customize to a whole new level and makes your Android device awesome. The third reason is some awesome apps that run on the Play Store require root access, so that's another good reason for getting root access on your phone. Fourth, the microprocessor. When you get root access, you can also control the microprocessor and CPU of your device. You can use a technique called overclocking and underclocking to control your device. And overclocking the CPU simply means that increasing the CPU speed, which increases the performance of your device. Also, it also drains the battery. Conversely, underclocking the CPU means practically putting your phone in hibernating mode, and which helps to save battery life. Although you must do these tunings carefully, otherwise you could damage your device. So there are a lot of reasons why you should get root access in your phone, because by editing the system files, you can make your phone a lot awesome than it is right now. Talk to you about the advantages of getting root access into your device, but now you should also know the risks you run by trying to get root access into your device. The first danger is voiding your warranty. The instant you root your device, the warranty provided by a device manufacturer is completely void. Although this doesn't matter to many Android users trying to customize their device, if something goes wrong while rooting and you rush to your nearest customer support to get the device fixed, you won't be able to get it done for free and you'll have to pay a fee. So please keep that in mind while trying to get root access. The second is bricking your device. Now, since most rooting methods try to bypass the default code in the operating system and try to get root access, there is a slight chance that this process may go horribly wrong and your phone may stop working. Such a device is known as a brick device. Hence, you should understand that when you attempt to root your device, you are missing a slight chance. It's very minimal if you do the steps correctly, but there is still a chance that your device may never work properly again. Most rooting guides on the internet caution you of the same, so please keep that in mind as well. The third disadvantage is security risk. By default, non-system apps cannot get access to your system file, but once you root, they have full access to your system files. This can be a potential security risk if you download a malicious app meant for your rooted phone, which has full access to your device's system files and can cause horrible damage. So please keep that in mind while trying to download apps for your rooted device. So enough said about the advantages and disadvantages of rooting. Now let's look at the methods by which we can root our device. There are two methods. The first method is ridiculously simple and can be used by beginners. It is known as the one touch root app method or the soft rooting method. It is as simple as downloading an app and clicking on the root button to get root access in your device. Although there are a number of apps on the internet for this purpose, I think the most trusted app for this purpose is the Kingo Root app, the download link for which I will provide in the description. And make sure that before you install the application, you go to settings, then click on security and check this option, unknown sources, which allows installation of apps from the Google Chrome. So once you have installed the app, all you have to do is just click on this root button and you will get root access. The second method of getting root is slightly more complicated, but is nevertheless the more conventional and safer method of getting root access. This is known as the command line tool method or the hard rooting method. I won't go into much details here right now, but I provided a link in the description which gives a tutorial to how to go about this method to get root access. Basically, you have to connect your device to your PC and give commands to flash a certain binary file into your device which allows root access. Although technically both of these methods work and are generally safe, I would recommend the second method because it is much more safer and is more conventional than the first one. Also, because the first method tries to bypass the Android coding by exploiting a security bug which can sometimes harm your device. So I would suggest that you use the second method of rooting, and the steps for which you can follow in the tutorial of the link given in the description below. Guys, in this video I've tried to cover the process of rooting, its risks and advantages, and the methods by which you can get root access in your device. I am again warning you, rooting your device can potentially harm your device and cause it to stop working. So I am not responsible for any damaged devices. Rooting your device, you do it at your own risk. So guys, thanks for watching this video. Please leave a like, subscribe to my channel. And if you didn't understand any step of this rooting, or if you're having a problem with your device, leave a comment below and I will try to resolve your problem. Thanks for watching.